All right, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this matchup in the semifinals of the Epicenter Dota 2 SEA Regional Qualifier between Mineski and Wuji. This is a best of three.
Dire team ban.
And the winner of it will move on to the into the finals, which it says it's a best of one on the Faceit site. Now that makes me think it's sort of a placeholder. I think that the top two teams might move on to the main qualifier. I might be wrong. I can't really find a whole lot of information on it, as much of it is in Russian, and I am not Russian. I'm not sure about that at all, and this tournament really doesn't have a whole lot of exposure.
10 seconds.
Not a whole lot of information is out about it, so I guess we'll see. Right now, the task at hand is to cast this best of three between these two teams. It is technically a semifinal. Right now, we still have the other quarterfinals still going on. It's WG and Rave, and Arcanus against Assail. With Rave currently up 1-0 in their set, and Arcanus is up 1-0 in theirs. And the winners of those two matches will face each other. So we're a little bit ahead in the bracket right now. So let's get into this draft. A couple of bans right off the bat. Faceit's Void seems to be a ban that happens very early for most, for a lot of teams.
Dire team pick.
And both of the drafters really seem to have the same thing in mind here. Both very high push lineups. We've got Nature's Prophet already picked up for Mineski. And then the Beastmaster Enchantress, very good at pushing the waves and early wave clear there. So we might see the teams just butt horns a little bit in this match.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
And it is going to be the Chen.
Dire team
so very, very highly pushed, push-centered lineups here. I should probably change the title on the stream. Let's change that. All right, so we changed the title. Nice. And that takes us into the next phase of bans. So we've got the Sven banned out for Mineski, as well as a Gyrocopter for Wuji.
Remaining.
Both some of your carry heroes that are pretty good at the early dominance.
5 seconds remaining.
Gives your team a lot of armor and can cleave through waves pretty quickly.
Reserve
Very
time.
Standard second phase ban for the teams. As well as the Gyrocopter. Usually the first stage is heroes that you just don't want to see in a match, or you might be respect banning out for your opponent. But the second phase is usually more based on the first two picks and what the team is going to go for. So you definitely don't want to have a Sven and Beastmaster combo. That would be pretty ridiculous. In any case, he's going to get banned out, as well as the Invoker.
Radiant team.
So we won't be seeing that in this match. And Mineski haven't really come across too many problems so far in their journey through this qualifier. Wuji going for an early Slark. It really didn't work out too well in the last match, and we'll see if it does in this match. I think it has a better chance right now with the Chen being picked up for Mineski. Last time it was an Enchantress, and the Enchantress is a little bit better against the Slark. Slark, though, he can go in against the Chen and just really take him out. You still have to worry about that Chen army,
remaining.
It's a little bit better of a matchup.
5 seconds.
And of course you can
remaining.
Do the creep stealing between the Chen and the Enchantress there.
Reserve time.
Dominesky are going to go for the Witch Doctor.
Radiant team pick.
We also didn't comment on the fact that Wuji banned out the Death Prophet. They also don't want that big push coming in there. Might also affect their mid pick, depending on who that is. Wuji also have looked pretty good throughout this qualifier.
10 seconds remaining.
Although their competition may not have been so intense. Although I guess you could say the same for Mineski.
Reserve time.
Taking a bit of time on the pick here. The Slark doesn't really work with the pushing lineup as much, especially because you need more of an advantage to get going on a Slark, so
team pick.
You really have to snowball on that hero or try to come back, which is a little bit more difficult. I don't think it's so bad of a pickup here, though. Right now, Mineski doesn't have a whole lot of tools to deal with him, and it's only the Witch Doctor cast to disable the Slark so far, which is not that good actually against the Slark. Now you have the Lishrak to push.
Team back.
So we saw that in game one for Mineski in the last series. They pick up the Lishrak, and he's got that early lane as well as the Diabolic Edict to push down those towers. Back. So that will bring us near to the end of this draft.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Mineski taking quite a bit of time to think about this ban. It is going to be the Zeus.
Radiant team pick.
Yeah, interesting lineup here that Wuji have. They definitely can work with the Lion and the Slark to try to get some kills in that lane. Although the Lion can also just zone out the Prophet. I think that Winner could be in a little bit of trouble,
10
though.
10 seconds remaining.
With the Slark and a Lion against him.
5 seconds remaining.
And with the Chen in the jungle, I don't think there's a whole lot of rotations that are going to happen for him. So he's mainly on his
Reserve
own here.
Time.
Puck.
And the Puck will be the last pickup for Wuji.
Dire team pick.
This is looking pretty good, especially because Mineski don't have the tankiest lineup. They do have the Chen to give them some heals and as well as the Witch Doctor, but the Witch Doctors are very inconsequential. And, well, if you disable the Chen or if you silence him, he's not going to be able to get the heal off. So the Puck seems like a pretty good pick here, just keeping them
remaining
in place so that all the damage can come out.
5 seconds
as well as
silencing
remaining the enemy heroes. So I
Reserve time.
Think this could be a good matchup for Puck, depending on this last pickup from Mineski. They definitely get some much needed disables with the Lishrak. And if the Slark doesn't get HP like we saw in the last Slark versus, well, I don't know if we saw a Slark versus Lishrak matchup, but we did see Lishrak just outputting up a lot of damage against the squishier heroes.
Ember Spirit.
And it's going to be the Ember Spirit. So a very squishy lineup here for Mineski. The Ember can do well against the Puck with the Remnant out doing, well, going through the Dream Coil, so you don't have to worry about that. Although the Lion can just disable him, and that's just bad news bears for the Ember Spirit. We'll see how it works out in this game one of the semifinal between Mineski and Wuji. We'll just be waiting for the players to pick their heroes, and then we'll be getting right into this match. Alright, we're already going to get a pause here. Just making it clear that it is Dota that we are playing. And now we are ready to go. So we've got a TP already here by ADTR here for Mineski on the Witch Doctor. We've got Jacko on the Ember Spirit. Chan will be handled by Extinct. This Treant is going to be controlled by Winter on the Nature's Prophet. And finally, the Rashrak, played by Kesik Emba, going over towards the safe lane. We haven't seen Jacko on the Ember Spirit too often. Might be a good hero for him. Beastmaster for Wu Ji will be handled by NJ. The Puck will be played by Kang, just doing some damage to the Treant already. Johnny will be playing the Enchantress. The Slark will be handled by Aji.
And the...
let's see, the Beastmaster. Already looked at him. Lion. That's the one we haven't looked at. It's going to be played by X Nova. And, well, the Beastmaster. They're going to see him on the high ground there. They're not going to use any skills just yet. There's going to be the Sun. And the Spikes are going to come through by the Lushrak. This could be the first blood. Oh, they find it. Chen gets the first blood on the Beastmaster.
First blood!
They just go check the high ground. A prize. Actually.
Never refuse gold given.
Yeah, so they I don't know. They might have seen the Beastmaster there. But in any case, the Beastmaster goes down for the first blood. And look at these trains already being a nuisance on the bottom lane, keeping the creeps back. Oh man, Winter knows his heroes. Right now the goal here is just to do damage to the Spark, who does have a Scout Shield. But do a little bit of damage from the creep wave. They do end up taking the board down in the top lane with the net of the troll. And Witch Doctor will harass the Beastmaster. It's going to be the Coconut. He's not going to get in range for the stun though, and the troll also didn't have the net up there. The mid lane matchup is going to be the Puck against Jacko, who has to deal with the Centaur in there. Could get really annoying. And you on the bottom, we've got to pounce onto the Nature's Prophet. He gets the kill onto the Lion. This is just Winter's child's play right here. Usually he gets Goner and then he just goes for the Lion. That's his MO there. Wow, Jacko already very well in the mid lane. And he's forced to use the Fairy Fire. And now we'll use the Healing Salve to get Buck up, as does the Puck. Jacko's just going to go forward, clear some creeps with the Flame Guard. And already two kills right off the bat for Mineski. They got the first blood top, and then they also get Winter killing off the Lion bot. Gets an easy TP back to base. Lots of circlets.
Not for you.
Okay, on the mid lane, Puck still doing damage to Jacko. He's also got a tornado to worry about. Almost like he's in Kansas. This is an extremely annoying middle lane for Jack, who's just getting a lot of pressure put on him by the Enchantress creeps. And he's just forced off of this. Not doing so well against the Puck right now. Nature's Prophet continually scouts with those Treants, and he could get jumped on by the Slark. Just gonna get an Essence Shift to the back, and he'll pay for that a little bit. Oh, well, they're on top of each other in the mid lane, and forces Puck back. And now here comes the Centaur creep. The Sound's going to miss on the Jacko, but here's the Enchantress. The Stomp won't miss, and that'll be killed by the Enchantress on the mid lane Ember Spirit.
Don't even think about it.
Lion comes in from the side. He has the Hex and the stun available. He's not going to use it just yet. The Slark has taken a lot of damage here, and he does need to be careful this winter. He knows that he is no fear. He'll go right in. Jack goes back on the mid lane against the Puck, who currently has about a half level on him. And there is another tornado coming in on the Ember Spear. Man, he's really not having a good time.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Now Extinct rotates over to the top of the Diabolic, get it going. We're going to push down the tower with the Chen creeps. Make a couple of skeletons, spooky scary skeletons.
Radiant's structures
out a fortify, which is after the Diabolic Edict, which comes up again in 5 seconds. They're gonna put a board
Radiant's
here.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And this can be the first tower of the game here for Mineski. They're gonna put down the Diabolic Edict again.
Radiant's
and look
top
at the tower. Meanwhile, the bottom, we've got Winter taking a lot of damage. They're trying to do it. The work onto the Slark. He's turned to into a frog, and Slark will get the last hit there underneath the tower. Winter again tried to do his normal thing of just hitting down a hero, focusing a hero, but in that case it wasn't really enough. The Ember Spirit did manage to run in out of that Dream Coil. So the first Dream Coil of the game for the Puck is a bit of a whiff, and Jack will get his bottle back from the courier. The Slark was rather low and manages to get out of that bottom lane. Not yet level 6. But he has done rather well in this bottom lane. Got 19 last hits. That's sort of well, I guess. But right now the Lishrak is pretty much even with the Puck. And they will find the Beastmaster in the jungle here. Jacko doesn't have a stun, but they will get a rock through by the golem, and they're forced to, well, they almost force out a TP, but Puck is just going to stay in the mid lane.
No.
We have the Puck in the middle of a couple of heroes. There's going to be a stun onto him, and isn't able to go to the Dream Coil. Illusory Orb. The Dream Coil is available. And we'll see if Puck goes on this one. A little bit of maneuvering here by the teams. Alright. So not either team really taking a whole lot of an advantage right now. They've got to run attack by the Ember Spirit, and there could be a rotation. Does the bounce come through by the Ember Spirit? And Jacko is going to take the Nature's Wrath. Jacko going in a little bit here. Still has that remnant back. He's got the Dream Coil, and while the stun's coming from the line, and the Ember Spirit goes down the mid lane, as does the Witch Doctor. Right now, Jacko playing on the Ember Spirit. We haven't really seen him play that yet this tournament. And he ends up going down a little bit too aggressive there.
Dire structures are fortified.
Probably just need to get out. But they do have the Lishrak, who did take the top tier 1 tower down. A push continues on the mid lane. Coconut goes through. There's a jump back and continues to hit around. The Nature's Prophet will come in, and he's actually going to get blocked up by the Chen. Probably a good thing, too. They might not have wanted to go in there more. Alright, they're not going to get the successful D ward onto the Sentry. So that might force the Dire back here. That's an observer ward. You need a sentry. Alright, they get the sentry. Oh, that was... They might have just wasted an observer there. Jack was going over to the top lane, trying to get some easy farm here. He definitely needs it. He's not done so well. Alright, in the mid lane, still got some engagements going on. Puck has a Dream Coil available, as well as the Elusive. The Legend is going to come through, and the Dream Coil does come out. The Castle goes through onto the creeps. Just force the Puck out a little bit. There's going to be another orb coming in by the Puck, just spamming out the wave, making it so that Lishrak has to back up. Jacko is fully scouted out here by the Hawk. And they know where he is. That's it. And Lion comes in with a stun, turns into a frog. He got the Hex. There's a Roar available. Are they going to be able to get Jacko down? He has a Remnant, and he gets out. Wow. Just being able to tank through everything with that Flame Shield. And on the bottom, well, Slark gets rather low to the Winter, but he's going to be fine, and he's still going for that Hand of Midas. Jacko making an engagement onto
Pull roots and run.
The Lion. Does he get out? Just misses the Searing Change. And in that case, a value point in the Sleight of Fist would have been good. You could have gotten a further range
Dire's
on the stun.
Middle tower is under attack.
But it's understandable why he's not getting. He's a bit behind on the XP right now. And he needs to catch up before he can start going for things like that. More lightning going to get used on the Slark, and there's a dive out. Edic, the stun will hit onto the Slark, who has the ultimate available. He'll go into it and try to TP out, and they're not going to be able to find
Radiant's
him.
Bottom tower is under attack.
So the bottom tower taking a lot of damage. He's got the Chen army
Radiant's
on the Lishrak, and this is going to be probably the second
Radiant's
tower of the game going
tower
to Mineski.
Is under attack.
So they
Radiant's
will take the tower.
Tower
Winter has gone
fallen.
Over to mid, working on the tower threat. Johnny just prancing around, actually.
Dire's middle tower
takes up
is under attack.
Dream Claw, there is going to be the cast coming through. Hits a couple of times between the Puck and the Catapult. Ends up not doing much else there, though. So they need to profit. Gets hit by the full combo of the Puck. Just took a little bit too much damage there. Was underestimating what Puck was actually doing.
Catch!
And another cast goes out on Johnny. The Lightning Strike does hit. But that's going to be the end of that. And it looks like Lishrak wants to push in mid. He's currently level 8. And Puck is slightly low on health. Has 2 bottle charges though. And the Ember Spirit will push in top. He's got a bottle coming back to him. Interesting. A bit deep for a Bottle Crow.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And the Diabalki will go onto that mid tower.
Radiant structures
of course out the Fortify, but here comes the Chen army, as well as Winter with the Treants. Net will go on to the Puck. Are they going to be able to get him down fast enough? They do. They take out the Puck here, and this could be Mineski's engagement here. They get the stun onto the Troll Creep only, and there will be a yell onto Winter, but there goes the Death Ward. Lots of damage, and they are forcing Wuji back here. 30 seconds on that Puck respawn. They've stolen the Troll Creep, and there's going to be another Diabolic feed on the tower, which eventually goes down.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Just going back up here. Jacko just going to push out the wave with the Flame Shield. And yeah, he's just going to continue to farm. He's got almost 1700 gold right now. And the thing about Mineski is they need to try to get their farm, and they'll do that by getting the towers, but they also need some levels here. So that's what the Ember Spirit is doing, just trying to solo push out the waves, get some levels. He's got two in the Sleight of Fist now, so the ganks are going to be a little bit easier for him. And there's going to be a TP in by the Nation's Prophet. He's got Johnny. He's doing a little bit of damage here. Slightly more. Johnny heal going, but it's not enough. Also, the stun from the lion came through, but not enough to save the enchantress there. And now the push comes in onto the bottom tower. So this is what Mineski can do. They get a pick off, go for a tower. They've also got the retract here to put down the lightning storm throughout the creep. The Wuji do take a tower in the top lane. But the Mineski lineup, they're just going right on the tower. Nice silence by the Puck, and he's going to jaunt back. They will eventually take the tower. Ember Spirit yelled at, turned into a frog. He will eventually go down. The tower almost down. Not down just yet. There's going to be another type of Balkidic by the Lashrak, which will probably take the tower down. He's a bit far from it now, and he's actually forced back. It's just one hit on the tower in order to get it down. Well, that's almost a full five-man team. Witch Doctor eventually gets a kill onto the Enchantress with the Maledict. And the tower can get denied. It was just one hit, guys. Why can't you do that? It's a 4-for-2 exchange, and Wuji get a chance to get back into this match. With Slark getting some gold there, as well as the Puck with the Blink Dagger. The Nature's Prophet did end up getting out of that fight. Double Null Talisman, Drums of Endurance. Slark is on the top of the net worth board right now. But like I said, he does need a lot of farm to get started. And he's still really working on that. I mean, so does Jacko. But Jacko's on Boots of Travel right now, so he's actually doing pretty well. Now, that does seem to be running back by the Ember Spirit. Wuji are going to push onto the mid lane with a couple of boars. They're going to use the Fortify. We'll see if there's a reaction here from Mineski. They have a Centaur, Puff will Phase Shift out, and jaunt back. And they will clear up these creeps. They can go for the deny if they want, but they decide not. Okay, they do. They deny the tower.
Dire's middle tower has been denied. Radiant's top
and Jacko goes off to clear bot once again. Jacko with the flame shield just pushing in bottom. You got Lion getting a nice D ward down. The sentry ward does have the observer in range, so they can go get that one too. Jacko going to find Slark in the jungle. He's got a tie to the impurities somewhere. I don't actually think he does. Being a little bit dangerous here. No, he doesn't have a remnant. And he goes back to mid, Puck blinks away as the Prophet TP's in. The Beastmaster does finish up the Necro one. And right now, Mineski with all the tier 1s down, and one tier 2 down as well, they have a couple of choices. They can go for a Roshan, or they can continue to push. There's a smoke here on the mid lane. Lashrak needs to be careful. He's a bit far up. Blink forward by the Spark, as well as the Puck. They've got a lot of damage, and the finger onto the Lashrak will take him down. Wow, that Nature's Wrath actually did so much damage to the Spark. But all he needs to do is break vision, and then he will be regenning. Meanwhile, Beastmaster gets taken down in the Dire Jungle due to the Ember Spirit and the Nature's Prophet. So that's a 1-for-1. About even there. And the coconut will bounce around the Radiant Creeps right there. Witch Doctor just holding his own against the line in the mid lane. We can take a quick look at the XP graph, which is in favor of Wuji right now. Plus the net worth, about even right now. So, the Slark and the Puck really keep their team in it. And the Beastmaster is starting to get a little bit effective in this game. He did end up going down in the Dire Jungle, but he does have a Necro 1. and this Ember Spirit getting closer to a Battle Fury. Smoke here by the Dire. Got 5 Bloodstone charges on the Wish Track. Last time we saw him with the Bloodstone, he had 21 charges on it. That was in a different match.
I'll take that.
And they could... We'll see where they decide to rotate. They're trying to do a little bit of scouting with the Chen army. I think they're going to try to go for this Beastmaster once again. Try to keep him down.
Dire's bottom tower is
here comes
under
the smoke, and he's back up. And there's the Remnant forward. Stun goes on to the Beastmaster Yell. He's not going to go off just yet. And Winter goes forward. They're going to try to clear off this tower. This is what they do. Get a pick off, get a tower.
Radiant's top
they continue
tower
to get gold from
attack.
This, keeping them in this game, even if they're doing rather well. Radiant's now they're trying to push in through fallen. Bot. Puck is forced back. He's going to go back to the base. And there's a big Chen army here. It's doing a
Radiant's
little bit of damage. Winter actually TP's in. Mineski is a little bit far in here, and Puck wastes the loose reorb. There's a fortify. They may want to back up right now. Winter uses the blade mail, and actually just takes a whole lot of damage tonight, but there's a death ward.
Radiant's top tower.
Basically,
tickle
King James a little bit, but the tier 3 tower almost down. They have another die about 6 seconds. Double stun here. Puck is going to get in there, gets the Dream Pool. There's also a Blink Ward by the Slark, just doing so much damage. Now Mineski, they're on the back foot. They end up taking the Slark down, and wow, that Kessick Imba just running in. They didn't take care of him. And there's a stun by the Lion, but that's not enough. Johnny missing uphill. Puck in the backside, trying to do as much work as possible. Bloodtrack about to go down, almost does. Has that Bloodstone trying to stay alive. He's almost underneath the tower. He will actually deny himself as Beastmaster almost gets a kill there. And Winter, he's got a Nature's Wrath available, which oh wow, Puck hits the blade mail. Radiant's top ferrets are under attack. I probably should have put the fight recap up there. Puck is back here. There's a Nature's Wrath available. Winter uses it. And the Puck is out of vision. Cole comes back in. Not going to get hit by it, though. Puck,
Radiant's
there's another Blade Mail by the Nature's Prophet. And he's going to get out. Has to use the Phase Shift in order to avoid the Blade Mail. And Jack is in here now with the Boots of Travel. And I really have to save him, but that's a finger. Oh, no. They take the Ember Spirit down again. And now Extinct has to try to get out. He is what they call... absolutely
God
dead.
Taketh whom he loveth best.
But they do end up taking the melee racks down, which is pretty important in that fight. Although they do trade a lot for it. Winter picks up a Maelstrom. It's a lot of damage from him, and he's also got that
just
blade mail, which was shown
ordered
a couple of times in that last fight. There's a Silence onto the Lishrak. He's got 6 charges on the Bloodstone. He could be in a little bit of trouble. Puck uses the Dual Scepter onto the Lishrak. And Lishrak might want to fight here. He's going to be a patient of the Puck. The Sun will miss. He's going to jaunt into the trees. Nice, beautiful, and look at this. There's a lot of damage right there. Which is going to get yelled at by the Beastmaster. Beastmaster is taking a lot of damage. However, the Enchantress is able to get the kill. And it's Jacko who gets a stun. Yeah, he gets the Beastmaster down with those Searing Chains. Now, Jacko. He's walking around. Johnny's going to TP out. They decide they don't want to go for this Ember Spirit at all. Lots of kills are on the bottom lane.
The Ember Spirit are fortified.
Getting in there at the end of the fight, kind of securing things a little bit. It was a really interesting fight. I mean, the Puck comes in trying to take a couple of heroes down, gets a Dream Quill from the trees. Unfortunately, they weren't able to take him down fast enough so that he couldn't jaunt away. Ember Spirit finally finishes off the Battle Fury. If we take a look at the other items, Lion has an Aether Lens. And Slark has finished up the Yasha. Hey, that's about it. Of course, there's a mech on the... NXP still in favor of Wu Ji. And net worth is pretty much back and forth right now. Slark gets out of the top lane as Ember pushes it in. Here comes the spark. Has that Blanken. Wow, that's a quick remnant out by the Ember Spirit. They do have the bird scouting out the Roshan if Mineski were to try for it. I think they probably should. Maybe they'll go for the tier 2 first, but usually you want to use that Aegis for a high ground push. And once again, if you can find a pickoff, you can get a tower. Mineski just hanging out here a little bit, trying to find their next move. They are definitely the aggressors in this match, even though they are slightly behind on kills. Lion just sitting in the tree, not for the blink just yet. And he could walk out here. Oh, this Ember Spirit could get caught out a little bit. He's just gonna run it out. And the impact it still hits. Look at all the damage it does. That's ridiculous. Chen Army just sitting top, waiting to push it in. And the puck has a plate mail. I'm guessing that's going to be a Shiva's guard. Lion getting pretty close to the blink dagger, and we may see a Roshan attempt. They're smoked in the base, and the bird is about to fly over. And they see the Ember Spirit going over there, so they will be informed about this Roshan. And Puck will put the Illusory Orb in. Mineski don't do this Roshan particularly fast. They do have the Chen creeps to tank up, but that's about it. Now, there's a nice Glimmer Cape on the track that's going to get him out of there. If he didn't have that Glimmer Cape, things would have been a little bit dicey for him. You have to be careful about that. So Winter, again, going to continue farming. Extinct. I'm guessing that's going to be...
Roots and run.
I don't know what that headdress says. Oh, it's a Vlad's. He's going for a Vlad's. Ember Spear also has a Blink Dagger, so it's going to be pretty difficult to kill him here. And he'll just run them back to the bottom lane after pushing out top a little bit. The puck is indeed going for a Shiva's guard. Gonna give him a little bit more mana and slow down the attack. Although, I guess slow down the attack of the Nature's Prophet. That's possible. Although, it's really only for one hero. Puck a little bit far forward. Could get hit by the coconut. But the phase shift backwards will save the puck for now. Track one to stay on the wave with the lightning, as well as the Pulse Nova. Not to be confused with Luna's Nova. Or as they call it, Nova! Merchant makes a career selling mayonnaise. The Illusory Orb by the puck comes in. It's going to scout out this Roshan attempt, and they're going to do it kind of quickly with the Diabolic Edict. They have to do it pretty fast. The puck has another Illusory Orb. Gonna use it now. Gotta be careful. You don't want to be taking too much damage. Puck is going to blink in. Actually, that's Larkin. The Dire is going to take it. They take the Aegis. Now Lushrak has taken a lot of damage. He's popped the BKB. And he will go down to Lushrak by the Flark. The Chen heal a little bit as well. And they're trying to take off the Lion. Lion turns the Ember Spirit into a Frog. He will end up going down to the Nature's Prophet. And now Jacko. That's three down already, and he's forced to run it away. The Impetus again does some more damage. Well, the Yule Scepter is going to break the Council of the Slark, and
the Embers still
Aegis is going to get popped. We'll see if he's able to get out of it. He could run it back. He's going to run it there. And he's going to avoid the Impetus with the Sword of Fist. He's going to get silenced here, and he may get away. Johnny underneath the tower. So they end up with three kills in the popping of the Aegis. As Wuji just taking advantage of the Roshan positioning there and getting a great Dream Coil. This Ember Spirit still working on the items. He could see the Enchantress, he's just going to Remnant away. Being pretty safe here. He doesn't really want to mess with the Radiant at all right now. Still though, one outer tower remaining. If Mineski can find the pickoff, they can get these towers. I keep saying it. But the thing about Mineski's lineups that we haven't really seen other teams do is they pick heroes that allow them to take objectives, and that's how they end these games really well. They don't allow the other team a chance to get back into it, and they always make sure that the other team is punished for their mistakes. The Ember Spirit has an orb now. Might be building into a Lincoln's so that he doesn't get hit by that roar, which I guess he thinks is a problem. And the Lashrak has two charges on a Bloodstone. Definitely not where he wants to be on that, although it really only takes a couple of big hits in order to get back into it. Puck blinks to the south as the Lashrak continues to push him through bot. And, well, the Enchantress has a Dragon Lance and the Point Booster. The line has finished up that Blink Dagger. This Blink Dagger on the Spark has been used pretty well. He also has a BKB and a Sanjin Yasha. The Beastmaster also has a Blink Dagger as well as a Necro Book. Right, looks like we have another pause on the board. As Wuji, they're having a couple of problems. In terms of other places on the bracket, Arcanus ended up winning their match up against Assail 2-0. And like I predicted, WG took the second match against Rafe, so that series is tied at 1-1. And you can definitely watch those matches in the client if you go to the Face It tournament under Amateur Tournaments, go to the Europe subsection, and then under Face It, the match will be right there. And that should be... It should be starting now, if not soon. Yeah, they're in Hero Selection right now. Winter continuing to get the farm up. He hasn't really been as much of a presence in this match, but he hasn't been dying. Which is a pretty good thing. Not dying is cool. Looks like the teams are ready to go in a bit. We've been casting for about 2.5 hours now, and we still have a little bit to go. This is only game one in a best of three. Still waiting on them to start. Man, I'm getting like 265 ping to this, but it doesn't really matter so much when you're casting. When you're playing, it's a different story. Still waiting to get started back up, and it looks like we are ready to go. See, we will get right back into this. And Jacko's just farming up some ancients. So is Winter. He's gonna Remnant out. Beastmaster still working on it. He's got a Blink Dagger, which is going to help a lot in these fights, and really his roar is just doing a lot of work for Luigi. On the top lane, Lashrak could get caught out. Bark comes in with the leap, and Lashrak is going to BKB to get out. Puck is going to chase a little bit. He turns back. And, well, Jacko comes with the blink. He's gonna get yelled at, and his mana is gonna get stolen. He does not want this one. Here comes Winter, and he is going to try to help. Uses the Sprout, and the finger goes through on the Jackal. He will end up going down, but not before Winter is able to get a kill. And the Beastmaster is trying to TP out. He's gonna miss the Sprout, and Winter has to TP. That's a bit aggressive by the Ember Spirit, and an Ember Spirit for a Lion, not the best trade at all, and that's reflected here. Spark just going to be taking his Shiv to the Ancients there. It is nice and sharp. Getting a lot of gold here. Gotta use that Midas. Talk to be careful, but he does have the Spark here to help out against this Lashrak. The Space Pony. Who hasn't really made an item for a while. Would like to see him get a bit more tanky. I'm guessing it would be an Octarine on him. And here comes the TP in by the Lashrak, as well as the Nature's Prophet. There's a nice stun on the Beastmaster. Beastmaster now going to go down on this bottom lane. And this is nothing. Maski just make the rotation. And they're a bit far away from a tower now. Ember Spear will try to push out mid. Puck is ready with a Dream Coil if it's needed. As well as the Lion. Lion gets a Hex off onto Jacko Jacko. One get hit by the Shiva's Guard. And now we'll see this shot to come in. Guard coming in from the backside. There's a Glimmer Cape onto the Ember Spirit, keeping him alive. The Clerk trying to go in against the Witchhunter. We'll keep the kill there. On the front side, Winter with the Blade Mail. It's going to expire in just a moment. And the Clerk will get out. But the Winter stays alive. So it's a Beastmaster on the bottom lane, a Witch Doctor on mid. But the Court for Minescu stay alive, which was the goal of what the Witch Doctor did there. Ember Spirit almost at that Lincoln Sphere. Minescu are building up their items really slow here. Not like we've usually seen them. Puck has finished up the Shiva's Guard, and they'll see about pushing off bottom. Also, Puck has a Gem of True Sight, so they're going to get out a lot of these wards that the Dire have put on their side of the map. It's very quickly taking them all out. They do miss one D ward since it middle expired. Tower is under attack. They continue to get their farm up. Ember Spirit keeps nearing that Lincoln Sphere, about 400 to 500 gold away from that. And are there any items that I missed? Sark has a Javelin. Be interesting. I'm guessing that's just going to be a Skull Basher that he's going to build. Guishi actually looking pretty good in this match.
Illusion.
We'll see if Minescu are able to pull this one out. Like I said, they definitely have better presence when it comes to pushing towers.
Double damage
and
empowers me.
They still have three towers that are remaining against Guishi, so they're looking pretty good in that respect. Although with the Beastmaster aura, Guishi have a pretty good push themselves. They just need a little bit more pressure on the tower in order to do it. And right now, going into Minescu is really scary for them. Spark is going to take away in the mid lane. He'll leap away. right now, Winter, he's going in on a Johnny, and he's also going to get a TP in from the track, and the Ember Spirit is here as well, and Bougie, they were trying to lay a trap, but little did they know that the trap was there for them. This is a triple kill for Jacko on that top lane, and meanwhile, in the river, Spark could get caught out. He's going to leap away, trying to go on to the Witch Doctor, and here is the TP in by the Nature's Prophet. Spark is going to regen up and get out of this one, but they're just going to push him to mid. With those heroes down and no buybacks available, they could be getting a tier 3 tower here, as well as a set of racks.
Radiant's middle tower.
Diabolic Edict goes through onto the tower. The Radiant do have a
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
So we may only see a tier 3 tower go down. Tower's taking a lot of damage now. And there's going to be a Shooting Guard. Dream Cola by the Puck doing so much damage along with the Spark. It's going on to Winter. And now there's going to be a BKB used. The Dark Pack will finish off the Nature's Prophet. And now a Shooting Guard trying to get out. Ember Spirit just trying to warn them off. So they don't quite take down the tower. About half damage there. Oh, there's a Yule Scepter onto the Ember Spirit. A little bit aggressive there. And he's got another Yule Scepter up to the north. There was a nice Centaur stun. They were thinking about TPing in there, but they decided not to. That would have been a little bit aggressive. And Ember Spirit continues to be really aggressive here. Spark just trying to chase him down. And Ember Spirit's out of there. Wow. So close and very greedy. Now he's going to be going for a Yasha. I'm guessing that's going to build into a Manta style to avoid the silence of the Puck. That's a lot of utility items that your Ember Spirit is going for, and not so much damage. That's a bit worrying. I don't know why we're just staring at a Roshan right now. Let's do something useful. Extinct is going for that Aghanim Scepter, and he'll be pretty close to it. It'll help him push a little bit, but it loses its effectiveness later in the game. Mishrak is also getting closer to an Octarine Core. Make him a little bit tanky. A little bit more tanky, that is. And Lestrak is getting scared off by the way. He's going to get yelled at, and there will be the Dark Pack as well as the Finger. Not even worth reacting to for me.
Chained in searing heat.
Jacko gets the chains on the Puck, and he'll go over to the jungle and continue to the south. Puck probably thought that he was going to try. Oh, wow. He blinks right onto the Puck, and he's going to run him back to the other side of the river. That leaves Bougie in the Roshan pit, and then without a Roshan, it's very unlikely that they're going to go onto this. I think they must know that they're going for the Roshan, though, because Winter is pushing in top as well as the Ember Spirit. So they are taking objectives elsewhere on the map, even though the Roshan is getting taken. Or at least pushing in the lanes. Jacko just TPs in there, or blinks in there rather, and doesn't really do a whole lot. So Jacko's finished up the Lincoln's tier. He's going to be close to a Manta style soon. In fact, he might already have the gold he wants to keep a buyback. Enchantress for some reason holding the ultimate orb of the Slark. I guess he's going back for Scotty after he got the Skull Basher. This Slark is going to be very tanky and difficult to deal with. They're really going to need this Ember Spirit to come through. And I guess other heroes, they need the magic damage of the Lushrak when the BKB isn't up. Prophets will be doing stuff, maybe even getting that Scythe of Vice off before the Slark can do anything. It's going to be a tough... It's a tough list of things that you need to do there. In any case, it's 40 minutes into this game. Things have slowed down quite a bit. Right now, Mineski are looking for some pickoffs across the map, and they can react pretty fast to these with these pickoffs. He goes over to the bottom lane, going to Shadow Blade, and see if he can find the pickoff. He might go right into the Sentry Ward, and he's going to just back up. Dark Blink's forward. Could get hit here. He actually hits the leap onto Winter. They truly acted onto Extinct. Winter pops the blade down. Taking down the Beastmaster, but that's a double kill for the Spark on the top lane. And, well, space created. There's Jackal on the bottom lane, going for the rack, going for the mouse. NT dodges one of those in Pedicy. And another.
Where are you going?
Wuxi could find the Ember Spirit in the jungle, but he's actually going to go to the east, and they'll miss him a little bit there. And we haven't looked at XP or gold for a while, so XP a little bit in favor of Wuxi, and gold very slightly in favor of Mineski at this point. At 40 minutes in, that's a very small gold difference. The Ember Spirit's farm is pretty good. He's doing Ancients right now. Just trying to get everything off the map that he can. So, the Lincolns gets popped by the puck, and Jacko is right out of there on the Ember Spirit. And he puts another Remnant out. Hang comes in with the Shiver's Guard to balance the Ember Spirit, and now he's going to go right in on the Puck. Puck gets the phase shift and now has to get out, but here comes the Ember Spirit. He's got another Slight of Fist. Doesn't want to go any further.
Double damage.
Spark at level 25 right now. He's got the Scotty. The Abyssal Blade. This is, wow, this Slark got a lot of gold here.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
A bit surprising. Enchantress has also finished up the Aghanim Scepter. Jacko just went to the bottom lane. And Kang is here. See what Kang decides to build into next. There are a lot of things to pop the Lincolns of the Ember Spirit, and if this Slark goes on him, this Ember Spirit is just dead. They're gonna have to find an answer for him. They're going to find the Witch Doctor in the trees.
My
they will yell at him. They will take him down. Wuxi looking pretty good in this game right now. Although they still have to worry about that top lane pushing in.
A tithe to the impurities.
Jacko, for some reason, will get fingered down and silenced. And the Beastmaster is... Sorry, the Aegis is out too. I don't know why the Ember Spirit decided to do that. It was clearly a lot of people there, as the Witch Doctor just got ganked. Maybe he thought that they backed up or something. Maybe he wants to kind of bait Wuxi into pushing. Hoping
Dire's
that they can take a fight
under
at bot, but I don't know if you would really want to expend a buyback
Dire's
for that purpose.
Bottom tower has fallen.
Winter turns Johnny into a pig, and that's the Enchantress. They're taking her down very slowly, but they also have a lot of magic damage. They will take out the Enchantress. Meanwhile, on bottom, they've got... they've got Spark going in. He does... ends up getting hit by the coconut, and he's behind the tower though,
Radiant's
trying to do whatever he can.
Under attack.
Wow, the Nature's Prophet. Look at Lushrak just trying to stay alive. He's got the Bloodstone, he's going to deny himself. This just shows how annoying the Nature's Prophet can get. You try to push in a tower, and well, what's gonna happen? You've got your Nature's Prophet and your Lushrak just pushing in. Your base. It's so difficult. Your Chen also has the Aghanim Scepter, so we can get some ancient creeps now. You got the big creeps from Chen's side now. And Nature's Prophet just trying to get everything out of this map. This presents a little bit of a problem here for Minescu. Like, they're trying to get a lot out of this map, and Wuji are at a point right now where they can just gank you, and this is the point of the lineup. They have a lot of heroes that can pretty much solo you down. And even if they're not soloing you down, they'll have help, and it'll be very scary.
Oh, look at it go!
The Witch Doctor. He's got the monkey on his back. Looks like they might want to try to get a gank onto the Beastmaster, who is able to blink away. So that's probably just off the mark. But here's the Ember Spirit. There's a yell onto the Ember Spirit, and well, the Hand of God is going to be in time. This Jack is going to be able to get out. He has the... No. He turned into a fish, and he's not able to get out of that one. Now the track going to get bashed up by the Spark. He uses the BKB and Witch Doctor in trouble. He uses the Death Ward. Not going to be enough time there though. And now Kessler Imba. The BKB runs out. And while he's using the Pulse Nose, not going to be enough though. The Ember Spear buys back. He's going to get back into this fight. And the Spark has to buy back as well. Lion turns Jacko into a frog. But he's going to go down to the Winter. Who he buy back as well? I don't know. Beastmaster buys back. Only the Ember Spirit. Now, Kang goes right in. He's turned into a pig by the Nature's Prophet. He uses the Face Shift to try to get out of the one. Here comes Spark. The Ember Spirit is going to Remnant out. He doesn't want to get too aggressive here. And the Nature's Prophet gets out of there. The Chen, however, not going to be as lucky. And they will also take care of that army. So a big fight there. Minescu get through a couple of buybacks while expending one of their own, and now this Ember Spirit does have to be really careful. He's gone for the Chrysalis, and he can just go right for the Daedalus. It's not that big of a deal if you have buyback down. So he can just finish up his items. Slark has a Hyperstone. I guess that could be an Assault Curious. It's not usually something you see on a Slark. Usually you don't see him going for a Hyperstone in these situations. Winter, Invis, turns Puck into a pig. They're doing a lot of damage to him. They need to do a little bit more. He's got the Phase Shift, he's got the Orb out, but there's the Witch Doctor ready. And the rest of Luigi are showing up right now. Ember Spirit, he got out of this. There's a yell on the catching Kimba. The Finger comes through. He's not even getting the chance to activate the BKB. And on the backside, Ember Spirit doing work against the Enchantress, but she doesn't really care. The Witch Doctor did get taken down back there. And the Ember Spirit, he might try to outmaneuver Wuji. He's got the Remnant on the high ground. He's trying to clear out the creep wave mid, and he'll just get right back out. Making sure that they can't push him easily. Look at how far all these things are pushed out. Right there, meeting right there, and there. They're basically stuck in their base, and there's nothing that they can do to even get close to these 2-2 towers. Ember Spirit will continue to farm up. He's got the recipe for the Daedalus, and is getting pretty close to the Demon Edge as well. Ember Spirit just waiting in the jungle here. We could see Winter and Jack the Gain taken care of here. Puck is ready with the orb, gets the coil onto both, and Winter breaks the coil, tries to get out, but he's going to get a Whistleblade by the Slark, and he will end up going down here, so he still has buyback. Track will just be handling the bottom lane. Minescu is still trying to find stuff on the map. Witch Doctor could get caught out. Maybe they have a smoke. Might have a smoke. Yeah, they have a smoke. And they'll go in here. The Nature's Prophet is still down. And Wuji are all together. They're gonna have to find a really good pick. It could be the lion. The glimmer cape on the witch dragon. He's gonna blink right out. Pop has a info available. The yell goes on to the witch dragon. He's stuck there. The beastmaster, though, he's down, but he's already used the yell. Stand back actually goes back on the witch dragon. Nature Trap has bought back in this one. Jacko gets hit by the abyssal blade. He could go down. This would be him down for 120 seconds with no buyback. Gem of Crusade is on the ground and changes this, doing so much damage with the Impetus. And Winter, he's trying to do as much as damage as possible. Mineski, they could be in trouble. Extinct trying to get Johnny down. He ends up getting him down. That's a triple kill for Slark, and all of the heroes are down for Mineski with only a buyback on the Chen. That is definitely not enough to do anything, but you do have the lanes pushed out quite a bit. And, well, the Chen army is going to take care of mid. It's a 3,900 gold change. And the creeps are pushing in top. So Wuxi can't really do a whole lot off of this. Slark is going to go take Roshan by himself. But they're not going to be able to push any towers. So that is going to give enough time for Mineski to respawn. Ember Spirit has buyback in 2 minutes. It'll be interesting to see where this match goes. I mean, at this point, either team can take it. Wuxi really has to work on pushing out the lane so that they can try to take objectives off of these fights.
Oh, how I wish I had this back at Dark Reef.
A prize.
Stark is going to drop the boots here for a gem. We'll see if he gets any D wards. I mean, he can see where the wards are.
Silence.
With his passive. But sometimes they're hard for him to access. This witch track really needs to stay alive a little bit more. He does have the Octarine Core, but at this point, well, he could get a Shiva's Guard soon, which will help a little bit against the Slark and the Beastmaster, I suppose.
A tithe to the impurities.
He does have to keep the buyback up, though, and he still needs about 100 gold for that. The Puck, he's going to be working on the Linking Sphere of his own. Mineski are gathering up here on bottom. They could find the Spark. That would be a really big pickoff for them. Oh, but they have them scoured out. So much pinging going on. They've got the Hawk there, and they see the... Well, I don't know what they saw, but they know that they want to get out. Jacko's hanging out at
Fame
the top
will spread thrice.
Nature Prophet going to push in top with the Chen creep army. Shiva's Guard just comes out from the Puck to push that out a little bit. They're doing a little bit better pushing these lanes out. But Mineski just has so much to work with, making it very difficult for Wuji to even get close to the base. It's a very highly contested game number one, 53 minutes. And the game is still very much up in the air. So a couple of graphs for you. The gold's still very even. Oh, meanwhile on bottom, we've got a roar onto the lift track. He's going to get bashed by the Slark. Now Kezakimba uses the BKB, trying to get out. He's not really getting any help from his team at all. Here comes the Dream Pool, actually going to completely whiff. And now Extinct trying to get away to the west. Puck taking a lot of damage from that dive ball. Edict. The Lashark has gone down and he does have buyback. Winter being a nuisance on the back of the fight, just taking out the creeps. He is going to try to back out. And there's a Yule Scepter onto Winter. Winter could be in trouble. Well, the Winter, he's going to go down. The Ember Spirit went down mid. His buyback is also... He doesn't have enough gold for it. Wuji, this could be them going for the base. They quickly take care of this tier 2 tower. Slark has 17 stacks of Essence Shift. Not really the most you can see, but it's still quite a bit. And they can work through these creep waves pretty fast.
Dyer's
with
middle
the Mjolnir on the Enchantress, they put Dyer's the buff onto the Slark. Fortified. They're going for the tier 3. Ember Spirit down for 70 more seconds, as is the Nature's Prophet, just getting so many kills across the map. And Dire's middle tower. They can go for. They're fallen. Trying to go for the tier fours. There's blink forward. Silence onto extinct. The coconut going to go through. There's a nice spaceship by the puck. And well, they're gonna go for the racks. Now there's a tier four. Chen brings his army to him. Witch Doctor's got to be careful. Blink forward by the puck. There's going to be the Lincoln Spear popped. And there's a coconut by the Witch Doctor. Only going to hit. Oh, it's just bouncing around here. There's a BKB used. Lion's going to go down. Witch Doctor uses the Death Ward. He will go down as well. Svark just having his way with everybody here. Pucks blink forward. You've still got 30 seconds left on your Nature's Prophet. And Ember Spirit, the Spark is so low. He could get taken down by the Spear. That's just the Aegis, though. It doesn't matter. They're going to go for the Tier 4 Towers. Enchantress actually steals one of these creeps, and the Tier 4 Tower about to go down. They're all down for now, and well, the Ancient, it could go down. The Fortify not available. And with the Beastmaster here, the Ancient will go down even faster. Wuji, they spent most of this match on the back foot, but they will take this game number one from Mineski in the semifinals of the Epicenter Dota 2 SEA Regional Qualifier. What a finish, 56 minutes. And Wuji, they hung in there. I know they had a lot of push against them, but they came back in the end, and they're going to take this match from Mineski. We'll go to a game two, and we'll have a short break. Stay tuned, thanks for watching, and as always, cheers.